arrive very soon, I hope. It will not be the case. But sometimes someone's going to become very sick or may even be killed, die, because of residues. It may be a Chinese, because a lot of them is eating our Chinese, eating our macadamias. And when that happens, that's going to be a major disaster for us. It's not if it's going to happen, it's when it's going to happen. So what is the moral of the story? The moral of the story, it's a macadamia industry problem, because we cannot use these type of chemicals. Because of the withholding period, therefore we need alternatives. And that's where the research have to come in and to come up with alternative, maybe chemicals, but maybe even better is alternative strategies to control like stinker. It can be something like, you didn't know where the venue was. Oh, now you know. Strategies can include something like that you put out bait. In other words, you don't apply any chemical to the trees or to the nuts. Or you use a bait such as a pheromone that will attract the stink bug. By applying these type of baits or whatever, you can apply it outside the orchard and it can attract the stink bug there. And when it gets into contact with the bait is poisoned and it will get killed. That is the way we do it with fruit fly. In lots of crops. They're working on it. Dr. Carl Schumann is doing a lot of research on that at the ITC. He's busy about 5 years now and not much success yet. And the reason is these African stink bugs is horrifying. It's like the back row there at the back. Now you must understand these two major stink bugs in macadamias is the big green one spotted stink bug. That's maybe about 60-70% of all damage to macadamias is done by that. So the question is, what are we doing now? What can we do? And there's not an answer. That's why it's a massive, huge problem. And that's why, if I do ask you a question in the exam, and thanks to the back row that will be in the exam, and I will exactly ask on macadamias, and citrus, and avocados. As a matter of fact, I can ask one question in the exam for 100 marks. You see how horrible I can be. Thanks to the background. The background is there again, it will become even more difficult.
is good land.
The issue here is, I want to pick another example of an industry problem, and that is on citrus. And this is the way I want you, it's not always necessary, industry problem is not necessarily always a cultivation issue. Okay? It can be a market issue. It can be, in the case of citrus, I want to put it this way. We do export most of our citrus, we export mainly to the European countries, to Germany for that matter, is importing a lot of our citrus. It's also going to Japan and to China and to the United Kingdom. But the European Union, that is the Western Europe countries, they tried their luck. Before I go there, we're not unique in citrus production in the world. There is also countries in Europe that's producing citrus, such as Portugal and Spain. And their citrus is not bad at all, but they don't like a country such as South Africa interfering in their market. They see the European market as theirs. So they will do all sorts of things to try and get us out of that market. So what they did is, they started lobbying and saying, we have got CBS, citrus black spot, in South Africa. We do have got citrus black spot for many years. Even when Yampa Rivia came here, there was CBS. When the Poisson was here, there was CBS. Okay, so it's here for a very long time. Citrus black spot is a fungus. Citrus black spot is especially in areas such as Hayibu, Nelspruit, Limpopo, Marlboro, Tongasdal, but not in Addo or Citrusdal in the Eastern Cape and the Western Cape. And the reason is the disease is there, but the conditions, especially climatic conditions, is not suitable to get symptoms on the fruit. So the clever people that think they're clever, as the back row of saying again, they think they are clever, but they're not that clever. Meaning, they thought by putting this as a problem to the import of South African food, they can kick us out of the European market, but it didn't work for the simple reason. The fact that we had the CBS for a long time, our fruit is infected, yes, with the fungus for forever, in the past and many years. But because of the conditions in Europe, because of the very cold winters, you'll never ever get citrus black spot in Europe. So it is not a threat to them. So they thought they were clever, but they were not clever. So when that we had the opportunity to show them, listen, you're talking nonsense, you don't know what you're talking about. You try and use things that is not the truth. We were able to convince the European Import Council Board that it's not a threat to them, and they still kept the import for South Africa, because the Germans especially will only but buy South African citrus. They won't buy Spain citrus, they won't buy Portuguese citrus, and they'll never ever buy citrus juice in a bottle. They'll buy the fruit and they want to make their own juice. That's a German. Now, you will never change that. Okay. And that is a very unique brand, actually. It is a threat to us if they put these stumbling blocks in front of the industry. And that is the way I expect from all of you to go and define problems related for the different crops. And I'm doing this on purpose because you must get into the library. You go and read in the library. There's citrus journals, there's a lot of agricultural books and stuff. There's the computer that you can utilize. And have a look at, you can Google and say, industry problem, have a product in South Africa, and you'll get a result. But now, I'm not interested only but to know what problem is there. I want to know, and you'll have to discuss it the way I've discussed these two things to you now. Right. It's not that good. The students, they're supposed to study every day. No. And actually what I'm doing now with you is to help you whenever you go and you finish with your undergraduate, when you start your postgraduate group or whatever, you'll have to come up with a topic that you're going to do research on, even if it's honors, even if it's masters, even if it's PhD. You'll go through a whole process that you must address an industry problem. Therefore, you must define it correctly. And your methods and methodology is very important. And that is what the researcher is. Okay. So, this is the way I assume you will utilize in the future a lot, is whenever you can do it in agronomy, you can do it in fruit, you can do it in whatever you want to, because I'm not sure what your degree is really all about. I spoke up in a meeting at the school board meeting and asked them what's the university going to do to